Explaining the universe from the solar system to the farthest reaches of space with authority and humor. That is the topic of Neil deGrasse Tyson's newest book, To Infinity and Beyond, A Journey of Cosmic Discovery.
Neil deGrasse Tyson joins us now. Good morning.
Good
Thanks
morning.
For being with us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me. Great to come off of that story with the sphere, because with, you know, astrophysicists and spheres, we go way back.
Yeah.
Stars and planets and the rest.
I got to tell you, you know, you have always made, I mean, I kind of tune out when I hear space stories. It's just my eyes glaze over. But you have such a creative way of explaining things to people. What will people get out of this book, this newest book of yours?
Well, what we honed in my podcast, which is called Star Talk, and this book is a product of the collaborations that is the podcast, is we combine science, pop culture, and humor. And when you stitch that together and you present the science in that way, what we found is that people come back for more. And so that DNA is imprinted in this book. And it's a journey of mind and spirit and technology and science from our very first thoughts standing on Earth, wondering, can we ever ascend? First into the atmosphere. The first of those folks were called aeronauts, and then into space, to our backyard, and into the farthest reaches of the universe. There are fits and starts. We start with Icarus, whose wings melted, right? So do you say, oh, I'm giving up? Or do you say, if I'm going to make wings, I'm not going to make them out of wax, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm proud that I'm part of a species where people do not give up in the attempt to ascend, even if the science and technology isn't ready yet. And this book tracks that. And the scenery that we bring to you, the pop culture part, is there's always a movie out there that attempted to display what we're describing. And then I'll comment on the science they might have gotten right or wrong.
Yeah.
And that just gives you should eat popcorn as you go through the
yeah.
book, because that's part of the experience.
A lot of those movies involve aliens. We did a story about Mexico's Congress, and you probably saw this. It was a news conference. A guy said he's got bodies, alien bodies. And then, of course, there's the film from the fighter jet pilots with the Tic Tac video. And what do you make of all this?
So I love that they brought forth the alien bodies. That's a start. I found it odd how humanoid it looked, okay? Because most life on Earth, with whom we have no DNA in common, does not look human.
Uh-huh.
Okay? So that's odd that this would be aliens from another planet. But it also, did you notice it had a nose?
Yeah.
A 1,000-year-old mummy, there's no bone in your nose, all right? There's a big cavity in your skull.
Yeah.
They had noses. Yeah, that was a little weird to me. So here's what needs to happen. When we came back from the Apollo, we had moon rocks. We sent them around the world to scientists. Here, they need to share this with other scientists around the world so that we can verify or falsify the claim. And what the press does is they get one claim that's extraordinary, and they run with it as though it's the truth. That's not how science works. It always has to be peer-reviewed, verified, double-checked, checked by your competitors, and only then, if we have common answers, then we can declare that we have a new objective truth in the world.
What about
so
some
I
of these...
think it's great.
Yeah.
Yeah. What about some of these videos we see from fighter pilots? I feel like we never get a clear view with all these cameras out there. Everything still looks like an Atari game from 1982.
Low risk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's funny. I joked, I think on Twitter or X, I joked, I said, maybe the aliens are actually fuzzy, so we can't get a sharp picture
yeah.
of them. You know, we all have video cameras. You know, when I grew up, nobody had a camera unless
right.
you were on vacation. So
right.
you could experience something and not get to tell anybody about it. With 6 billion smartphones in the world, we have the capacity to crowdsource any possible alien invasion. And there's a million people at any moment who are airborne with
yeah.
a window right next
yeah.
to them in the airplane.
Uh-huh.
And so I'm thinking we could do much better than the Navy.
Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, thank you so much. The book is To Infinity and Beyond, A Journey of Cosmic Discovery. It's out now, and his social media is on the screen. Thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.